Hello there, it's Ina here, and welcome to my art room. So I use simple acrylic paint and my brush to start a background on my square canvas here. Now this collaboration is actually all about pores and a technique done with balloons. Now, I do work with balloons all the time, but never on a canvas, never in my mixed media, and even pores are rather new to me. I've done maybe two or three before. So this is definitely going to be an experiment and an adventure. So let's just see where it will take me. As you can see here, I used a sponge to blend out the background some, and now I added more paint and some water so I can get some drippage. I know even at this point, this is a rather unconventional way to start a pour, but I have this idea. I don't know if it's going to work. We will see. Here I use my hairdryer to blow the water across the canvas. And as you can see, it makes rather nice design. So I'm going to play a little more and do this step one more time with mixed results, because some of the paint just became too thin on the top. So I decided to just use my brush to blend it all out. And it worked really well because it left some lighter areas, and I think it looks rather cool. So here starts my pour. I prepared the paint just with some pouring medium and simple acrylic paint. It has no other chemicals or anything in it. And I choose three colors, white, brown, and yellow ochre to start with. And as you're guessing correctly, I'm going for somewhat of a mountain design here. And right from the start, I'm already fiddling with my palette knife here because I think I added way too much paint for the small strip of canvas I'm using, and especially way too much white. So if I kept tilting it, most of my color would just float off the canvas and I'd be left with white only. So yes, I'm putting color back, picking it up from the runoff, tilting a little bit, putting more colors in, yeah, tilting it the other way, and so on. So I know everybody who does pours will probably say, what is she doing? This is not the way it goes, but well, it goes like this for me at least today. So I'm trying to work with it, adding more colors, messing with it, and even using a little pin to make some finer divisions between the colors. I'm basically just running with it. While I am playing with it, adding more color and so on, I just want to mention that this collaboration was organized by CAC, Creative Arts Collaboration, a Facebook group for YouTube creators. And like I put in the title, there will be more information on that and on this whole collaboration down below in my description box. Okay, now it's time to use a balloon as a tool. Now I did find a couple of videos to watch, so I have a basic idea how this is supposed to work. I know after this event, there will be plenty more videos available on this technique. Now, overall, in hindsight, I think I approached it a little bit too timid and a little bit too controlled. Anyway, I start with white circles first, and then I add some orange, yellow, and red paint just with a paintbrush to the bottom of this little balloon. These are actually big red round balloons, but I only blew them up a tiny bit. I have a couple laying around. Let's see how many I will need. So that gives a really nice effect. I like the way that looks, and I play with it a little more, get a little more red into it. And after a while, I switch over to also add some teal for some of the other circles. As I'm working on this, I can clearly see this is going to turn more into a mixed media painting than a pour, but I poured paint and I did use a balloon, so I think I'm going to be okay. So here I'm using a second balloon to blend out the bottom of those mountains because I felt they needed to be grounded a little bit. Then some white splatter over the background just with acrylic paint again. And now I might as well go all the way. So I take my paint roller, some black acrylic paint, and give this painting a frame. This works super well, super quick, and always leaves a nice straight line, even though it's a little fuzzy. And I like that look. And next I'm adding some of this ultra thin metallic foil. I just use a little Mod Podge on my finger and randomly apply the foil, and a lot of it will come off as I work it with my dry brush, but it leaves enough to give a kind of a fun, subtle effect. So I do some of it on the mountains and I do some of it on the circles. I found a huge stack of this foil in different metallic colors at a local store, and it's really fun to work with. Here you can see a close-up. So it's rather subtle, not too much. Now at this point, I decide I need a little more contrast. So I use my balloon one more time to add some black circles. And that pretty much brings me to the end. And this project turned out a little bit different than I had planned. And I will definitely do more work with pores and this balloon technique. Now, before I close, I added a bonus clip here just for fun. As I mentioned earlier, I work with balloons all the time. My husband and I, we run a small party business, and we are balloon twisters and face painters. Now, I'm fast, but I'm not this fast. I sped this up 4 times because I did not want this video to take too long. Now, I live close to Denver, Colorado, and during the football season, I make this little horse in white, blue, and orange for the Denver Broncos, and it's everybody's favorite, especially the adults. Anyway, I hope you don't mind me showing off my twisting skills here, but I think we all have hidden talents, and sometimes it's just fun to know. Okay, my little horse is nearly ready. I hope you enjoyed my project. I hope you enjoyed this little clip. Make sure to check the box below for any more information. See you real soon again. Bye-bye for now.